Currently on the Purple Alphabet, we're doing videos on restaurant kits or activity kits to use when you travel or go to the doctor's office. However, we're not doing that much anymore. So I had to come up with a new way to use these in our house, and I wanted to show you what I came up with. And I also have a giveaway in this video that is sponsored by ThinkFun. Hey, you guys, it's Christina from the Purple Alphabet. Now, I know you know what these are. They are my restaurant kits that we take to the restaurants to keep our kids entertained while we're waiting for our food, and they're packed full of ideas. And other people are using these in other different ways, like in their cars, in their restaurants, when they have a boring moment in their house, when they go to church, but I need a different reason to use them now. So I thought I'd come up with a different way to use activity kits in the house and show you what I came up with. Normally I use these cases because I like the handle, I get their travel and go. I like the size because if it doesn't fit in here, it doesn't go with us. It's a hard surface that they can write on. It's clear and you can see what's inside. However, I think for home use, we're gonna use a little something different, which I'm gonna show you in just a moment. But if you want one of these cases, they are available at Daiso Japan for $1.50 or on Amazon for a little bit more. But you don't always have to use these, and I'm gonna show you what we're gonna be using at home. I also owe you a giveaway winner. So we had a giveaway for ThinkFun just a few days ago. So if you see your name here, congratulations, you have won. You have 72 hours to respond to claim your prize. If you didn't win, don't worry, because ThinkFun's also sponsoring a giveaway in this video. And I'll tell all those details at the very end. So let me show you how we're doing these now.
If you are at all a fan of the Purple Alphabet, you definitely know that these little boxes right here, these are my activity kits. Normally. Usually I'll show you what's inside of here and take them out on the next video to show you if they worked or if we liked them, but we haven't used them since my last video. We used them once, as you can tell, they're kind of messy. But I made these two kits and made a video about it right before everything happened and shut down. And we weren't able to use them but one time at a restaurant. So I don't have much feedback about them. And I was deciding I could redo them for you because a lot of you say these videos are some of your favorites that we do. And instead, I think I'm gonna leave them as is for when things, I guess when we can use them. So I'm gonna leave them as is. Now these containers is what I liked because they were easy to travel with. It allowed us not to take too much. Girls could carry them. But for home purposes, since we're gonna be doing it at home, these cases probably aren't gonna work. I'm always telling you guys to just get what works for you. If it's a backpack, if it's a box, if it's a basket, whatever it is, get it for you. So I didn't go out to buy anything. I looked around my house and I had this little Sterilite container here. And I think I'm gonna use this. One for each of my girls for my next go around. I'm gonna leave the lid off and just use the container to put my things in. And these are gonna be more so activity kits. Activity boxes, maybe. We're gonna start off with my second grader first. So what I decided to do is resurrect some of my busy bags because I have learned so much with my kids being at home for distance learning and homeschool that I know where they are and what they're currently doing in class. I can take some of the activities that I already have materials for and turn them into supplements to what they're already learning. So this is a busy bag for money, and I showed this in a money activity video a long time ago. So if you're interested in these materials and how they work, definitely check out that video. I'll try to put it there somewhere in the corner so you can click on it and go find it. So I'm going to take parts of this that I know she's working on and make it into a new busy bag for her activity box. I'm not going to use the flashcards. I think what I'm going to be sticking to is just the money recognition right now. So all of the coins here, actually take out the flashcards out of the equation, just the money itself, and then also the three-part cards. But what I'm going to do is pick out the coins that I know she needs to know for the three-part cards and put that into my busy bag. She knows this, but I just want to make sure she really knows it because I see her hesitate sometimes on it. So I have the part of the three-part cards that has the name on it for control of air so she can check her work. And then I have the ones where she's going to have to label with these little labels down here. So we're going to put this into a little busy bag, and then she can use her coins and she can place them on the cards and she can label. As long as I know she's got that, we'll move on to some of the other activities from that video I showed you, the money video. We are also working on time, basically advanced time. So in time, you start with learning on the hour, on the half hour, on the half past the hour, and then you learn all the increments in between. And of course, this is a good step after you've learned skip counting. These are time telling dice. I believe this is also from another video that was about time telling. The whole video is about time telling. If I find it, I'm gonna put it up there again. So you can go back and watch that if you want more activities. But because she knows how to count 55 minutes after or 5 minutes it softer. And by fives, this little die has all of the times in those increments. There's 30 minutes, 15 minutes, 50 minutes, and then this one does by the hour. So a really simple activity that I want her to do is to take her little notebook here. I want her to roll, and I want her to draw a clock with the time that she rolls, and just to write a couple of clocks in here. I actually wish I had a time stamp, a blank clock stamp, but I don't, but she can just draw it because she knows what to do. So she would do 9:30 on a clock on here with her little pencil and pad of paper. A very simple concept, but I know she likes these little dice, likes to roll them, and then she can keep track and I can check up, maybe have her do maybe five or so. We'll see how it goes. I'm always talking about taking bits from larger games and then to put them into smaller components. Here's a Lakeshore activity I got on sale. I think it's called Roll and Read. It's a word family game. Let's see, how old are we on this one? Ages 6 and up for 1 to 4 players. It's a whole game, but I'm just gonna take out and make it my own busy bag. So here's a little sheet that you write on. There's a timer and then some dry erase markers, but I'm not so worried about that because I'm expecting her to work on this independently. And I'm gonna put in a little busy bag here. So normally you'd play this game and there's all kinds of different word endings here, and you would be making some words, and then a marker and a score sheet. So when she rolls, I can see how many words she makes from what she rolls. And it's a great collaborative game, but if I'm making little activity kits to do on their own, I think that would be a good resource. Also want to note in here, they have some word lists here to check your work and to look, but I have a feeling I'm going to be working with her, so I'm okay with leaving those out for now. But taking apart some larger games, I don't know if that's going to fit. Let's take them out for now. We're just going to use it like that. Make a real simple busy bag out of smaller components of larger games. So I'm kind of excited about this. I think she's gonna like this. I also wanted to include a game for each of my girls. This is a brand new game. It's the one that ThinkFun sent over. This is cool because ThinkFun is usually a one person kind of game. These are new. This is a 2 to 4 person game, and this one's for ages 8 and up. So this is why I'm going to put it in her box, because she's a little older, although I have a feeling my 6-year-old can kind of grasp this concept. I'm very excited that ThinkFun's doing collaborative games because their games are always so well done. This game comes with 81 chicken tiles that have all of the chickens on them. You get 12 eggs, 8 infiltrate tiles, which are these blue ones, as well as these 4 steel tiles, 4 leader tokens, and 4 screens. So in this one, we're competing against our opponent to complete our chicken army. So it's a race. And then you have to be careful not to give away the identity of your leader. And if you know someone else's leader, you can launch an egg and eliminate the opposition. I've set up a game for you here for 2 players to give you an example of what it looks like. So when you start off the game, everybody starts off with 10 chicken tiles, which are the ones right here on the side. These are little shields to kind of hide with the work you're doing until it's time to reveal and to play the game. So what we're trying to do is create 9 matching chickens in our set of cards here. And so if we look at our chicken cards a little bit more closely, let me find 2 that match to show you an example. Here we go. So all the chickens have traits, and there's 4 different traits for each card and 3 different options within that trait. So for example, the 4 traits are a weapon, eyewear, shirt color, and footwear. But you can have 3 different options for your footwear, 3 different options for your shirt color and your eyewear and your weapon. So your job is to match your chickens. And if they match, it's because they have 2 traits that are similar. So right here, I see we have some different shoes. We have some different weapons, but our shirt color is the same and our eyewear is the same. So this would be a match. We need 9 of those to win this game. And your opponent's trying to do the same thing. Everybody, while they have their shields up, takes one of their tokens and determines who they want to be their leader. Then they place that token underneath that card, and they can rearrange their cards in any way they want, taking note of all of their matches or their no matches as they play. Once everybody's done that and we are set to play, we take away our shields and we get started, keeping an eye on the other people's cards and matches and trying to figure out who their leader could be. And in the first gameplay, you get a choice. You can draw a card, you can discard a card. Oops, I just noticed we don't have 10 cards over here. Well, let's fix that here. There we go. Now we got 10 and 3 eggs. So as I was saying, the first order of business is that you can draw a card, trade it with one in your yard, and discard one of your current ones. So if it's a card that you need that has matches, you'll definitely want to keep it. Or you can take this and discard it if you want. Or you might take the one that was already in the discard pile. If you think you know who their leader is on the other side, you may choose to do an egg instead and place that on the correct one that you think is the leader. If you're correct, that player is out of the game, you've done good. And if you're incorrect, you must choose 2 chickens from your yard to discard. And once you do that, you can no longer launch an egg because you need 10 cards to launch an egg. So you have to wait until you have enough. We do have these special tiles here. We have a steel tile, which you can steal a chicken from someone else's yard. So if somebody has one that you need, or if you want to be strategic and leave them an empty one, you could use this. Then we have the infiltrate cards. And if you take one of these and use it, you trade one of your chickens with a chicken of your choosing from the other player's yards. Then you must tell everybody playing about the chicken you gave them, one and only trait that this chicken has in common with their leader. Kind of gives away a little bit of secrets there. The end of the game is when every other player's leader has been correctly guessed by using an egg, and the remaining player wins, or when all of your chickens match your leader. This game has a ton of strategy, you guys, really thinking and observing all the details and being strategic about what you do with the other players. For my first grader's box, I was going to work on actually 2 different skills for the same skill. 2 different bags for the same skill. Geometric shapes. So she was working on this in class. And so I have these, and this is one of the very first Purple Alphabet videos I ever did, was talking about geometric shapes. But we have this set here, and I'm gonna link this and put the Amazon info down below in the description box, because I know a lot of you are gonna want this. These are geometric shapes in that old video. Gosh, what video was that, you guys? Someone needs to tell me. We have the Montessori 3-part cards in here. If you don't know how Montessori 3-part cards are working, I have a whole video on how to use them. So we're gonna use this because I want her to remember these names. So we're gonna put this in her box. It's just a really simple matching thing that I've showed you probably a couple hundred times. But along with that is this other busy bag, which I think I also included in that same video. And this is a sorting busy bag. So we have all of our shapes here. The free printable, I don't remember it offhand, but it will be in that one video. And then we have all of these different shapes of real life objects that she would have to put on the card. Obviously that's not correct, but she'd have to put it on the card and sort them that way. I like this one because it's a little bit more in depth than just these cards. So these are great for the models, but then in real life, what does it look like, right? So I wanted her to take note of those geometric shapes in real life by using these cards after we work on that. So since she was doing this in class, I thought it'd be great to pull that out as a review for something to reinforce what she's learning with her group on her Zoom calls. I also wanted to do this busy bag. This is actually part of a set. Let me see here. Here it is. It's one of these little pocket chart sets. It came from Walmart several years ago, where you slide the little cards in here. So I'm gonna include that in here because I thought this would be fun. This is just a really simple picture to word match. So we have a whole bunch of picture cards here. I'm showing you this one because I think it's something that you guys can create on your own very easily by printing out pictures and making your own busy bag. So you don't necessarily have to have this set. If I can find it online, I will put that down below too. But they also have the words that go along with it, and so she can find the words, this is not the correct one, and do some matching. For a child who's just trying to do this, I would definitely limit how much you put on here by just maybe putting 5 or 6 and having them sort that way. But for her, because she's at a reading level that's pretty good, oh, there's jar, found jar, where'd it go? Lost it already. I'm pretty confident that she'd be able to pick out the words she needs when there's this many of them. If not, I will go and limit and just take out a few. I just had jar, you guys. Where did it go? Okay, well, you get the idea. So this is just a simple picture to word match, working on some vocabulary and some reading skills here. Here, I'm hoping this blue easel fits into my box too. I pulled this idea from my, I think it was like space activities video, where I had a whole bunch of ideas for space activities, because at the time I had found these little clothespins that have planets on them from the Target dollar section, and I thought they were just fabulous. So I pulled this activity from that video, and it's going to be 2 parts, and this is not something from that video, but I thought we could do it in 2 different ways. The first way is to use this book of planets, which was in the Target dollar section too, and as we go through and reading the different sections, she could find the corresponding planet. Where's Mars? Here it is. And and hook it on to her page as she's reading about it, or at the top like that, and then have all the clips onto all the pages when she's done. So this is kind of an introduction, because I think when she looks at the pictures here, she's not going to necessarily know it yet. And then once she's confident in that skill, she can actually do the clothespins on the actual planet cards. I think it says that, yeah, it does on the back, so she can self-check if she's not sure. So I thought this would be a really good two-parter. Incorporates that fine motor skills. These are just so cute. Don't have these? Hey, take a Sharpie, write them on clothespins, print out some pictures from the internet, the planets, and just glue them on there, because that's essentially what this is. You can definitely make these yourself. You can print out flashcards of all the planets, and you can order a book or print out some facts if you wanted to on the planets yourself too. For her game, I wanted to put in this travel size Quirkle, which I've kind of held aside for her regular restaurant kit because I thought it would work well there. And you guys are always asking for some great travel games. So although we're not traveling now, keep it in mind. This one's from Mindware. They sent it to me for free to review for you guys. And if you haven't played Quirkle before, it's pretty easy. This one is for ages 6 and up, 2 to 4 players. The bag it comes in is super cute. If you've played the full size Quirkle, this is just the same. We're just matching colors and shapes, but you gotta use logic and strategy to do this one. To start play, everybody gets to pick out 6 tiles. 6. You don't show your players them, you just basically stand them up on their side like this. But because we're doing the YouTube thing, I'm just gonna turn them over so you can play along and see with me. Here's one player, here's another player. The first person goes, and basically what they're doing is a play of all the same colors or all the same shapes. So I see I have 3 shapes here that are all the same color. I have to bring my hand back up to 6 over here, so I got 3 more tiles. And then the next person has to either add to what has been done or discard and draw some new tiles out of the bag. So you can't have the same shape in the same run, so that wouldn't work. But if I had something the same color, I could. Or if I had more of the same shape, I think I could do those right there. Each different play that you make has different points awarded to it, and you can have no more than 6 in a row. Here's one. If I played those, of course I obviously set that up, that would be a Quirkle. So this is a fun strategy game, get you thinking. It's nice size for travel or for easy storage. And it's a very simple but yet critical thinking logic game. You always know I love those. We're gonna put this one in my 6-year-old activity box. I think she'd really enjoy this one. You guys, if you have a great idea that would make a perfect activity kit or a restaurant kit when we go back to restaurants, let me know down below in the comments. I would love to hear your ideas, or even how you're using these in your house. Is it a reward? Is it just something to do when you're bored? I'd love to hear your thoughts. We also have giveaway details. So first of all, make sure you are subscribed to the Purple Alphabet YouTube channel. Love to have you be part of the family. And then of course, leave me a comment down below telling me how you use your activity kits. Then head over to the giveaway link to officially enter to win. Think Fun is giving away 1 copy of Chicken War. So you have to be at least 18 years of age or older and have a U.S. postal address. And of course, I do little bonus clues here and there so you can score some bonus entries. You guys, click subscribe to see more videos like this and give me a thumbs up to show your love.